your memories of the game against Portugal?
Oh yeah, it was crazy. Obviously, making my debut and to make my debut against the likes of Cristiano Ronaldo, obviously one of the world's best players ever, Bruno Fernandes, all these quality players, and to make it out there, and obviously the result is not what we wanted, but just to be out there and battle with the boys was great.
And you weren't overawed by the occasion or the quality of the player you were up against?
No, I wasn't.
So since then, you've become almost an ever-present in the Ireland team. The last few games you're in, and you've seemed to have grabbed the opportunity with both hands.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's just football, really. You get opportunities, and you just need to kind of be ready to take them. And obviously, with the international, it's a privilege to play for my country and stuff. So when I get my opportunity, I'll just always give them 100% towards it.
And for Norwich as well, in getting in.
Yeah, so I played just two games off there. We obviously got a win against Brentford there on Saturday. So yeah, hopefully you can continue.
And how important is it to finish this campaign strongly?
Oh, it's massive. I think there's a lot of excitement around the team now, and to be shown in the last couple of games there, we're coming together and we've got a couple of good results. We're scoring more goals than we have been. So yeah, it's an exciting time.
Thank you.
Can I have it?
Hi Will, can you talk us through your journey to being called up into the Ireland squad, please?
Yeah, so it actually first came on the radar quite a few years ago under Mick McCarthy. That was when I actually declared for Ireland. I think he was sort of considering me for selection then, so quite a few years ago now. And then I think just since the start of the season, the manager has been coming to the games and watching, so with James. Also, obviously, being a regular, I think he'd maybe had a couple of discussions with the manager as well. And, yeah, he just obviously kept an eye on me, and I was delighted to be included in the recent squad. That was a great experience, and, yeah, just looking forward to more.
And what was it that sort of convinced you to declare for Ireland?
Well, my dad's Irish. He was actually born in Sligo. He was sort of raised there, and then he was actually an orphan. He went to boarding school in Dublin, and then he was adopted and he moved to England when he was 10. So I think when I was a younger lad at the time, obviously I was approached by England first. So played sort of in the youth age groups there, and that was just, obviously I was living there, that was seemed to be the thing to do at the time. And obviously then further down the line when I got the opportunity to come here, it was something that I really wanted to do. Unfortunately my dad's kind of lost touch with his roots, for obvious reasons, we've sort of been given away as a child, but to sort of reconnect with that and have the opportunity to represent Ireland is a massive honour and something that I'm really proud of doing.
Sorry, did you say he's died or he's still alive?
No, he's still alive.
He's still alive?
Yeah, yeah.
So how proud is he?
Yeah, massively, yeah. Like I said, because of the circumstances, he hasn't sort of stayed in touch with his family, so for me to be able to represent Ireland and sort of, for him, obviously, growing up, he lost touch with it, so to sort of reconnect with that is a massive thing, and he's really proud, and for me to give him that, yeah, obviously gives me a lot of pleasure.
Andrew, can I just pick up on another topic? Obviously, you lost your manager on Saturday straight after the match. Can you just tell us how you found out, when you found out?
It was after the game, obviously. Obviously got the win and stuff, so it was a bit of mixed emotions, obviously going through the boys, and what he's done for the club is just amazing. I don't think I need to go through what he's done in the last four and a half years he was here, and personally he's been great. He's been obviously giving my debut and kind of put me in the window, obviously, to be here for international, kind of gave me that stage. He put his trust in me to play in big games in the crunch time of the last season in the Championship, and he's trusted me to give me a couple of appearances this season, so I'll be forever grateful for.
Who actually told you that he had gone?
I'm sorry?
Who told you that he had gone and been signed?
I was just around the club. We just knew when we got back to the training ground, that's when it was announced to us.
So you haven't been able to speak to him, or have you? Since?
Yeah, we've all spoken to the boss individually.
And as you say, it came as a shock to all in the squad?
Yeah, definitely. Obviously, we had a lot of faith in him, and obviously we've all been working with him for a while now, and we're all very close on, but it's kind of the nature of the game, is football.
Thank you very much.
Paul?
Hi lads, Andrew, quick one to start. How do you stop Ronaldo?
don't think there's a set way to stop Ronaldo. I think obviously we give respect where respect's due. He's obviously the best player in the world, but at the end of the day, it's 11v11 on the pitch, and we're all human, so I think it's just going to depend on the day.
Yeah, if you keep him quiet though, do you go a long way towards getting results against Portugal? Would you say that?
I think the Portuguese have a lot of good players. They have quality players all around the pitch. So, but yeah, it would definitely help massively.
Cheers,
Damien.
Just one other place. Ireland's have a tradition of very strong central defenders. Who would you have admired growing up in the Euros have been?
In the Ireland setup or in general?
Well, I
think my main idol would be Rio Ferdinand. That was back when I was growing up, and as I started to kind of get older, watching the Van Dijks and stuff kind of turn into the world's best and stuff, so I kind of like to watch a lot of players in my position from different leagues, different countries and stuff, and trying to kind of just nitpick from their games and maybe some that I play similar to, so I can kind of bring it into my game and stuff like that.
Who are you taking most from, anything in particular you take from?
I think stay with Rio Ferdinand. I think, yeah, he's my favourite, and he still is, even what he's doing after his career and stuff is kind of, it's just good to see.
Ed?
Well, there you go. So just to bring back, obviously your dad obviously had a hard childhood, and in terms of, I'm just wondering, did he sort of stay out of your decisions as younger in terms of not pushing to play for Ireland or anything because of his own experiences? And can you give me an idea of like what, you know, has the last few years, is it almost like a family voyage of rediscovery, almost, in that sense, of reconnection?
And
would that be any way, you know, of what's happening, or
Yeah, I mean, when I was a young lad, I was kind of approached by England at first. That was just kind of the option that was there on the table, and that's what I did at the time. Like, my dad didn't really have much input into that. At the end of the day, it's my decision. Obviously, he respects what I do, and when I first heard of the opportunity to play for Ireland, that was the decision I made. Obviously, that I wanted to focus on that, and that was my ambition, to try and get around the squad. So it's not to obviously it's nice that he can obviously reconnect with his birthplace and stuff, but no, I mean, for me, it's the opportunity to represent the country and just give everything that I've got.
Cheers.
And
Andrew, just I wanted to ask you about breaking into the Norwich squad into the first team and trying to establish yourself. Obviously, a team that's struggling in terms of league position. Is it harder for you then to come in and cement your place? You know, because you might only get one shot. You don't want a team that's trying to really consolidate, get the win and get a bit of momentum going. Was that tough? And I suppose you've come in and you've taken the chance. So you must feel really good about your position then, have you?
Yeah, I think it's a position for any young player. Obviously, we know we hadn't had the best of luck with results, but I think as a young player, it wouldn't really matter if your team was winning or if you were struggling. If you got the chance, you'd try to give 100% because at this stage of my career, I'm still trying to obviously establish myself and wherever I go, if it's even at an international level, if I play games and stuff like that, even if it's back-to-back games, I'm still have that mentality of like I need to still solidify my position.
Yeah.